Hello from Magna Golf Club. I'm Lindsay Hamilton alongside TSN golf analyst Bob Weeks. And Bob, the curtain has been raised. The stars are out and Canadians were putting on quite a show for fans. Phenomenal performances from both Brooke Henderson and AC Tangay. Your initial impressions from their opening rounds?
Well, a wonderful day. And I guess we sort of expected maybe that would come from Brooke. We weren't expecting it from AC Tangay. Both are great performances. I thought the crowds out here were spectacular as well. So great weather, great performances. Boy, what a way to kick things off.
Well, for Brooke Henderson, she is competing in her 8th CP Women's Open. Let's take a look at how it all went underway in the first day. The Brooke Brigade out in full force to cheer on the defending champion. Henderson even par through 4 holes. And that's when she started to heat up. Drains the birdie putt on 5, moves to 1 under. Then on 7, her third shot on the par 5. A great chip that sets up another birdie. Henderson now sitting on 2 under. Let's head to 9, looking to close out the front 9 with a bang, and she would make no mistake, finishing the front 9 3 under, 1 shot back the lead. Then on 12, finds herself with a tough bunker shot. Well, tough for the average golfer, not for Brooke Henderson. That, a tap-in for birdie, moves to 4 under and a tie for first place. To 15, another display of great iron control, lands it just shy of pin high, spins back, leaving the uphill birdie putt. Henderson steps up, knocks in another one, her 6th birdie of the day, now at 5 under, and she wasn't done. Skip ahead to 18, check out this approach shot from the rough. Sticks it, much like she did on the final hole of last year's CP Women's Open. Good for her 7th birdie of the day, a round of 6 under 66. Just an amazing start to the tournament for the 21-year-old. Here she is after her round.
This week's amazing. You know, to have this many people out on Thursday morning is pretty special. And, you know, they're cheering for me right and early, so that's pretty cool. And, you know, to get a solid round like this in front of them, I think is, you know, really a confidence booster for me. It gives me a lot of momentum going to the next 3 days. I feel like it's early, it's 1 round of 4, so it's nice to be in a position where I had a good round, everything seemed to go right for me, and you know, hopefully I can just continue to stick to my game plan, make a lot of birdies, and you know, I'd love to be in this position on Sunday.
Taking a closer look at Brooke Henderson's opening round, 4 birdies and a bogey on her front 9, followed by 3 birdies on the back 9, highlighted by that impressive birdie on the closing hole as she wrapped up her day in style. And Bob, the expectations surrounding Brooke Henderson as the defending champion are sky high. She looked calm, cool, and collected.
It was like a walk in the park for her out there. I think she got a little surprised by the weather because it was a little cooler and a little windier. But as she strolled along out there, you know, you would think there would be so much pressure on her. She said afterwards, though, it was exactly the opposite. It's because she has won this before, because she knows how to do it, there's no fear for her. She doesn't really have anything that's unexpected coming her way. So it was just really a matter of going out there and performing. And boy, did she ever do that.
Brooke Henderson has the experience at this tournament. She's playing in the CP Women's Open for her 8th time. Was there an aspect of her game that you liked particularly today?
I liked the game plan that she put in place, and that was really just keep things simple. Hit it in the fairway, hit it on the green. She only missed 2 fairways. She only missed 2 greens. In fact, one of the fairways she missed was that birdie you referred to on the 18th hole. And even from there, she hit her second shot into about 1.5 feet and tapped that in. But the one that was really, the part of her game that was really sort of a standout for me was her putting. And a couple of key putts really caught my eye. On the 9th hole, it's a par 5. She drove it right up beside the green, was putting for eagle, and kind of stubbed her putt, left herself about 15 feet. And when you're getting that close, you don't want to walk away from there without a birdie. Well, she rolled it right in the center. She came to the 14th, another par 5, and missed about a 3-foot putt. But it was a difficult putt, but still, that's a short one. You like to make that bounce back on the next hole with another really good 15-foot putt. So when those putts are going in for Brooke Henderson, you can see her smiling.
A strong opening round performance. Of course, there is a long road ahead as she looks for a 10th career victory. And she was not the only Canadian fans were keeping an eye on. More highlights from Magna Golf Club. Lori Kane playing in a record-setting 29th CP Women's Open. Hits the bunker shot on 8. She would shoot 87 in round 1. Now Kane with 29 starts. Meanwhile, 12-year-old Michelle Liu making her very first start. The youngest player in the field. Had a good look for birdie on the 15th hole, but slides it just by the edge. She'd tap in for par, shooting 41 on her front 9. On the 18th hole, Liu with the green in regulation. Nice approach from the Vancouver native. She'd legged the birdie putt to this point and would go to knock in the par putt. Liu holding her own in the first round, shooting 81. And that wasn't all for the Canadians. Check out this scorecard. AC Tangay joining Brooke Henderson on the leaderboard. It is only round one. We might have a weekend with multiple Canadians in contention if Tangay can back up this performance that included 5 birdies on the back nine.
I was kind of watching golf a little bit. I saw it on TV this morning. I saw Brooke was playing well and I was just kind of laughing. I was like, wow, Brooke loves to play well, you know, at home. And it feels so good to be able to put a good round together for me today.
I'd say I am disappointed. I mean, there were definitely a lot of, taking the wrong club, bad chipping. Yeah, definitely bad chipping. I'd say, I don't expect much, but I also expect to play something that I think is, my average score.
You're 12 years old and you just played an LPGA tournament. I think that's a pretty amazing achievement, don't you?
Yeah, I'm definitely proud that I'm able to play here in the first place.
Bob, it was a historic day for 12-year-old Michelle Liu. She becomes the youngest player to ever compete in the CP Women's Open. She sounded a little disappointed after her round, but there's plenty of positive takeaways, aren't there?
Tons of positive takeaways for her. I mean, yes, she's disappointed. You can understand at 12 years old, you probably have some big expectations. You'd never been on a stage like this. It's nerve-wracking. It's a little bit of a change of what she's used to. She's never felt anything like this at all. So, sure, she's going to be disappointed, but my goodness, she's 12 years old. She's playing in the CP Women's Open. I mean, this is a huge stage for a girl who's just 5 feet tall and, you know, swings out of her shoes. I thought it was a great performance. I really have no issues. I think that she's going to come back on Friday and put together a really nice round of golf.
And she learned a lot, has a great experience. For another Canadian, AC Tangay, a bit of a surprising performance, but one that she can be extremely proud of.
Yeah, I mean, fans may be a little surprised to see her name up there at the top of the leaderboard. You know what? She is too. She admitted that after the round. She hasn't played a competitive round of golf in 4 weeks. She did do a little bit of fine-tuning before the tournament started with national team coach Tristan Mullally. He tweaked a few things for her, so she felt better about that. And she said when she got on the back nine, all of a sudden the putter just started to come alive. In fact, she was standing over a putt and started to laugh. It was a 20-footer because she knew it was going right in. I mean, that's the kind of days you get 2 or 3 times a year. And when they do come, boy, are they fun.
Well, we do know there's a deep pool of talent here, 96 of the top 100 players on the tour. It's something LPGA Commissioner Mike Wan has spoken about earlier this week. And you talked to him about a few other topics earlier today.
All right, Commissioner Wan, welcome back to Canada. I know this is a place that you've been familiar with for a long time, but you heard a lot about Magna Golf Course before from Lawrence, and I know a number of the players, and now you're out here playing it. How does it reach up to the prior words that they gave it?
I think it's one of the prettiest walks in the game. I mean, it really is special. I'm a little concerned because my irons have taken some damage on these fairways, but you'd have to look pretty hard to find a bad spot on this golf course. I've looked with some of my drives today, but no, it's a spectacular layout. It's forgiving off the tee, but it's a second shot course. I mean, shots into the green are going to be challenging, but it's beautiful. Like I said to Lawrence from Golf Canada, I would never know that I'm this close to the city. You really feel like an escape here. This would be a great place to hang.
Obviously, the word got out because the field here is spectacular, 96 of the top 100. And you said earlier that obviously when players show up like that, the word must be out for them as well.
Yeah, people have said to me, how do they feel about my tournament? And I said, players vote with their appearance. If they're here, they like it. And we've been over 95 of the top 100, I think my entire 10 years as commissioner. So players have voted. They love the CP Women's Open. And there's every reason why they should. It's a great purse. It's good TV. We play on incredible tracks. In August, this is the only place in the world that feels this nice. So it's, CP and Golf Canada do it right. And as a result, our players come.
You mentioned 10 years in January. You'll be celebrating a decade at this job. What are you most proud of in that 10 years?
I'm really proud of the team we've built. You know, I mean, at the end of the day, like I said many times, I stand at the podium and take credit for a lot of work that everybody else does. We've really moved the needle for women's golf worldwide. You know, back when I started 10 years ago, about 15% of junior golf around the world was girls. It was pretty much the future of the game looked just like the senior part of the game. It was all boys, a little bit girls. Today, about 36% of junior golf is women. We're well on our way to a 50-50 sport here in the next 10 or 20 years. So I think when I'm on a rocking chair someday, sitting on a front porch talking to my grandkids, I'll be most proud of how we move the needle for women's golf worldwide.
All right, you mentioned the fact that you'd love to have 155 Brooke Hendersons every week. What are the challenges that you face for, say, the next decade in this job?
Well, I mean, it's funny. When I started back in 2010, the first question I had in my press conference is, what are you going to do about all the international influence? And I said, embrace it. And everybody started writing. I thought, what did I say? And I think people now realize what I meant by embrace it. You know, one of the things that makes the LPGA work is we put on these incredible hometown events. I mean, we're here in Toronto, and it's going to be a great Toronto event for the people all around Magna. But we're going to let 175 countries eavesdrop on us. This is the Olympic model. Create a sports environment where the best players in the world want to come play against each other, put on hometown events, and let the world watch it on TV. And that's what we do every week at the LPGA.
You used to sell hockey equipment. Did you come to Canada with hockey? I mean, now you're here. Are your hockey days behind you?
Yeah, I think my hockey, although I have to say, I was also a TaylorMade for a while. When I left, I said to my wife, I think I've learned all I can learn in golf. I think we're done with golf, and who knows, you know, so never say never. But no, hockey was a great experience. It got me close to Canada. I spent a lot of my life in Montreal, so I'm familiar with Montreal taxes. I lived in California and Montreal, couldn't spend more in taxes. But no, I loved my time there. I loved the people I worked with, and it was exciting to come back. This, to me, when I took the job, felt like something I could do for the game. It felt like my chance to give something back. Just the opposite had been true. This has been for me. I thought I was going to give something to the game, but I've got something in my last 10 years. It's a special place to be. I'm glad I'm here.
All right, I know you got 9 more holes to play. Good luck out there.
Thank you very much.
And some of the world's best are back at it Friday morning, bright and early, 9:30 a.m. Eastern, 6:30 Pacific on TSN 1, 4, and 5. Be sure to check back every day for our daily webisodes on tsn.ca, golfcanada.ca, and cpwomensopen.com.